Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about a flow use case where I'll be calculating the number of open tasks per lead and then finally store the number of open tasks in a custom variable inside lead object. So without any further delay, let's jump in and implement this use case in Salesforce using Salesforce Flow. So before I start, I'd like to let you know that recently I published a video on my YouTube channel, how to configure the flow transform element. And in that video, I got a comment. Let me pause that. So in that video, I got a comment from one of my subscribers that how we can use the transform element to create or to calculate the number of open tasks per lead. And can we use that in a scheduled triggered flow? So that was the motivation for me to create this video. So thank you, Jeannie, to provide your comment. And this video is for you and for others who are also looking for the same use case. Okay, so now let's go back to the Salesforce org. This is my Salesforce org. The only thing that I have done to implement the use case is like I've created a custom variable inside the task object, inside the lead object to store the number of open tasks. So if I go to the lead object and go to the fields, you will find there is a number of open tasks and it's basically a custom number field. So with that, let's go and build the flow. So if I go to the flow right now, okay, so first I'll start with a new flow and it will be a scheduled triggered flow. So let's select scheduled triggered flow and click on create. Now here I'll choose the object as task because I want my flow to run every time a task is getting created and task is linked to a lead. So here is my task and I want to calculate the number of open tasks. So status equals not started or status equals in progress or status equals waiting on someone else. So these are the open tasks, which is basically tell me that the task is still open and it cannot be and, it has to be or. So any of these status will make the task open. So what I'm configuring here is a scheduled triggered flow, which will run on the task object every time a task is getting created or updated and the status is still this. Now, since it's a scheduled triggered flow, I need to put a schedule. So the schedule is basically, it will start from today. And let's say I want to run this schedule job at midnight, which is 12 a.m. And frequency is like, I want to run this daily. So my schedule is done. With that, first thing that I will do, I want to make sure that the task is linked to a lead, because task is an object which can be linked to any record. It can be linked to an account, it can be linked to a contact, it can be linked to a case, it can be linked to a lead. So I want the schedule trigger flow to run only when there is a task which is getting created and linked to a lead. So this validation is very important. So let's put that validation first in the flow. Validate that task is to a lead, and yes. So how can I do that? The record, and then there is a void is basically captures the record associated with the task. So now I want this starts with, so for each lead, so if I go to a lead record, I already have a lead called Deb. Lead record starts with 00Q. So I'll copy this one and put it here. So now it tells me this condition checks whether the task is linked to a lead or not. So if it is linked to a lead, then only I'll take my action. So what I will do here now, I will fetch all the open tasks. So for that, I'll get records, get all open task associated with the same lead. We're going to fetch all the tasks and is closed equals to false. So it means all the open tasks, and UID is basically record.nameid UID. And then I want to fetch all the records. So this will give me all the records, all the tasks which are open and also linked to the same lead record. With that, I will bring the transform element. Calculate the number. In the source data, I will put all the tasks, and in the target data, I will put a record type which is record, and the object is of type lead. So what happened? Done. Now this is important. So when I click on here, not on this individual field, when I click on this list and click on this dot target one, it will automatically show few options from the lead object. But all I want, this one should go to my custom field, which is the number of open tasks. So here, the moment I select them, it is telling me what type of aggregation I want to do. I have two options as of today. Either I can do a count or I can do a sum. But my use case is to count the number of open tasks. So I'll select count, and then the value is stored here. So that's all I need to configure. And once this is done, the last thing is that I need to update the lead record. So for that, I will go to the update record and update the lead record. And here, update records. I'll select specify condition to identify records. I'll select lead. And here, the lead ID will be the record.uid, which is basically this one. And here, I'll choose number of open tasks should come from calculate, and then number of open tasks. That's all I need to do. And then click on save and give it a name, calculate open tasks per lead, and then click on save, click on activate. All good. So my schedule trigger flow is ready. So let's review the flow from the beginning. So this is a start element. This flow will run daily at midnight. This flow will run on the task object when any of this condition satisfies, which basically when the task is still open. What it is going to do is going to first check whether the task is attached to a lead or not. If it is not attached to a lead, then I don't want my flow to run. If it is attached to a lead, then what I'll do on this ES path, I want to fetch all the open tasks associated with the same lead. So this is the one. And then I'm going to use the transform element to calculate the count. So here, and then I'm calculating the count. Here is calculating the count. And finally, once the count is ready, I want to store the value of the count, store the value of this count operation inside the lead object, inside the same lead object, and also update the lead object. So this is the way I'm going to update the lead object, by storing the count value. Okay, so this is the flow. So let's debug the flow, or let's test the flow. So here I already have this lead object called dev, and inside the lead object, if I go to the detail, I can see I already have two open tasks. So let me go to chatter and create one more open task. So here, let's go to the activity, create one open task. Paste the new task. Let's put some due date as this one, assigned, and related to this. Everything looks good. Click on save. Now, if I go to the detail, refresh the page, it's still showing as two. The reason is that my flow is not a record triggered flow. It's a schedule triggered flow. So it will run only at 12. There's two options that I can wait till midnight and come back and see. But I don't want to do that. No. What I want to do, I want to forcefully run this schedule job. So what I can do, I can click on debug and then click on run. So the flow ran, and now if I go to my this org and this record and click on refresh, what I am expecting is that the number of open tasks became 3, because initially it was 2, and right now I've created one more task and that's why it's become 3. So this is the way how you can use this transform element to not only do the sum but also do the calculate. And you can use this transform element not only on your screen element, you can use that in your record triggered flow, you can use that in your schedule triggered flow. So I hope this video is helpful. I hope you can use this transform element in your use case and get advantage of this powerful feature. So if you like this video, please hit the like icon, subscribe to my channel, and please share this video with your friend colleagues. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching this video. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.